We have designed a cooled box for our Raspberry Pi 4, consisting of a base with a support for the Raspberry, a support for the fan, a support for the fan controller relay module, also supports for connection terminals and a mesh cover. We have the Raspberry in a vertical position without a cover, with the fins of the coolers also in this position to facilitate convection cooling. As you can see, we already had some signals connected to the Raspberry pins. They are inputs for door sensors that we will ignore in this video. We have printed it with ABS filament since we have a closed printer, which has given us some warping problems. But if you don't have a closed printer, you can print it with PLA. The link to download the 3D model directly from Thingiverse can be found in the video description. In this video, we'll show you the entire process, from 3D printing the case to fully assembling it. You'll also learn how to connect a fan to cool your Raspberry Pi based on its temperature. And if that wasn't enough, we'll guide you step by step through configuring Home Assistant and automating the entire system. The Home Assistant operating temperature under normal load was 50 degrees Celsius. By implementing a new thermal design that includes a motherboard separation and airflow optimization, we have achieved a 5 degrees Celsius decrease in normal working temperature, even without activating the fan. This demonstrates the importance of good heat dissipation to ensure stable operation and prolong the life of the device. Naturally, this box could also be used to mount a Raspberry Pi 4 in a system that was not Home Assistant. Even the connections could be the same, but the automation would have to be implemented in the system that had the Raspberry, or the fan could also be connected directly to 5 volts and run continuously, being able to eliminate the relay. We begin the assembly by assembling the flange that will hold the cover and the clips of the connection strips. We also check that everything fits. Okay. Here we can see the electrical connection diagram. We must say that the relay is activated by a built-in amplifier at a voltage of 3.3 volts, while the fan is activated through the relay contacts and is powered by 5 volts. For assembly, we will use flathead wood screws with a diameter of 2.5 millimeters and lengths of 12 and 20 millimeters. Now that we have the electrical circuit assembled, we will screw the fan to its support with 4 12mm screws. We place the terminals, which we have put in for future expansions. The support for the Raspberry, taking into account that 2 screws must be 12 mm long and the other 320. We screw the relay plate with four 12mm screws that we previously inserted into the head protection to prevent electrical contact. We turn off Home Assistant, press Developer Tools, restart, shut down system. We disconnect the power, GPIOS, and the network cable. And we remove the Raspberry to be able to mount it in the new box. We remove the SD card and take off the old cover, leaving the Raspberry ready for assembly. Now we will proceed to the assembly. First we connect the four cables of the relay diagram, first the brown cable to terminal 2 plus 5 volts, red wire to terminal 1 3.3 volts, the black wire to terminal 34, ground, and finally the green wire to terminal 36, GPIO 16. We screw the Raspberry with four 20mm screws that we have previously equipped with head protection. All we need to do is mount the fan with three 20mm screws. We have finished assembling it at the production site to be able to connect the GPIOS of the doors. All that remains is to insert the SD card, connect the network cable and the power cable. The SD card slot is located in one of the diamond shapes on the cover grille. Now in Home Assistant we are going to install the system monitor integration to be able to control the processor temperature and other parameters that will allow us to see the status of our system. Settings, Devices and Services, Add Integration, Type System Monitor, Submit, Close. Click on a service. We will enable the Memory Usage entity. To do this we will search for entities not shown and within it Configuration, Enable, Update. We will also disable the following entities, System Monitor Disk Free and System Monitor Proce Python 3. We will add these entities to the dashboard, twice, first as entities to display the value at this moment and then as a historical graph to monitor the evolution of the magnitudes. Now we can visualize this data. Next, we need the integration to control the Raspberry GPIOs, as they are not included as integrations in Home Assistant. We have to use HACS integrations. We leave a link to the HACS installation video from the Smart Home Junkie channel. We click on the three dots, Custom Repositories. We paste the link also located in the description of the video. In type, we choose integration and add. We wait and close. In search, we enter GPIOD. We choose GPIOD. The Raspberry Pi GPIO integration should also work, but we use GPIOD. Download, we choose version and download. Restart Home Assistant for the changes to take effect. Developer Tools, Restart, Restart Home Assistant. After rebooting, we will create the switch that will control the relay and therefore also the fan. We will do this by pasting the code in the configuration.yaml file. We edit it using the file editor plugin that only needs to be added in configuration plugins, but it could also be done with a studio code server. File editor, open configuration.yaml, go down to the end and paste the code that we have left a link in the video description, save. Now we have to reboot again for the switch to be created. First, we check the configuration and restart. We add the fan Raspberry switch to the control panel. First, on the entities card. And on the historical graph card. We exit editing. We check that the fan starts when activating the switch. We can see how the processor temperature drops immediately. We just need to create the automations that start the fan when a certain temperature is exceeded and the one that stops it when it drops below a lower temperature. Configuration, automations and services, create automation, create new automation. Add trigger, entity, numeric status, entity, system monitor, processor temperature. Above we put 49 degrees, during we put 4 seconds. Add action, switch, turn on, choose entity, fan Raspberry. Save, name with fan Raspberry on, save. Go back. Create automation, create new automation. Add trigger, entity, numeric state, entity, system monitor, processor temperature. Below we put 40 degrees, during we put 10 minutes. Add action, switch, turn off, choose entity, fan raspberry. Save, name it, fan raspberry off, save. Go back. We can try to trigger the action. We check that the fan has started. Please like, subscribe, turn on notifications. This is the temperature graph when switching to the new box without ventilation. Temperature graph and CPU occupation during update of two ESP home devices. Observe how the fan has started.